गुड मॉर्निंग, लेट्स बिगिन। एबिलिटी क्वेश्चन एंड वी पीपल वर डिस्कसिंग सम काइंड ऑफ रिलेशनशिप्स दैट कैन बी वी पीपल हैव टू जस्ट गो थ्रू सच काइंड ऑफ रिलेशनशिप सो दैट वी पीपल विल प्रैक्टिस क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर्स व्हिच आर बेस्ड ऑन दिस वर्बल एनालॉजी। सो लेट्स बिगिन विदाउट टेकिंग मच ऑफ टाइम। आई immediately get the screen and you people just let me know if it is this is the last that you have done. In fact, lecture we people had quiz in, we people are going to My voice is not okay. So from my end, I think I have everything. Once again, I will refresh the connection. So people just let me know if it is the same issue. Is it clear?
Not, sir.
Okay, still it is not clear. Okay, so just wait for 1 minute again. Is it audible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. It
yes,
is clear sir. Now. There is no any echo or breaking.
No.
Ha. Okay. Fine. So we people will continue with this. So people try to remember that what we people have done earlier. So here. The relationship which we people are going to discuss, it is individual and class. Okay, so let's continue. I think that we were talking this one only. So lizard is the animal which comes in the reptile category. So in the same way, man is a mammal. Okay, then ostrich, its category comes bird. Ostrich is a bird. Again, snake comes in reptile. So lizard and snake, both of them are reptile. So similarly, butterfly. So what is a butterfly? Butterfly is an insect. Whale, again, man and whale, both are mammal. रॅट इज रोडेंट. रोडेंट मीन्स द जे कुरतडणारे प्राणी असतात, दॅट कॉल्ड रोडेंट. ओके, दॅट वॉज वन रिलेशनशिप्स. नाव वी पीपल हॅव हिअर अनादर वन, अँड इट सेज इंडिव्हिज्युअल अँड दे आर अ ड्वेलिंग प्लेस. सो ड्वेलिंग प्लेस मीन्स वॉट? दॅट वेअर युजली ॲनिमल्स दे लिव, देअर लिव्हिंग प्लेसेस, दॅट इज कॉल्ड ड्वेलिंग प्लेस. सो डिफरंट ॲनिमल्स लिव ॲट डिफरंट प्लेसेस. सो पीपल विल थिंक ऑफ डॉग. सो डॉग्स, युजली डॉग्स विच आर डोमेस्टिक डॉग्स, दे आर केप्ट इन केनल. सो डॉग लिव्स इन अ केनल. सो बी, सो अनादर वन इज बी. सो बी आर केप्ट इन अपियरी. सो अपियरी इज द प्लेस वेअर हनी बी इज अ केप्ट. देन कॅटल, कॅटल आर केप्ट इन शेड, वी ऑल नो. Lion lives in den, so den is nothing but it is called cave. Poultry, where is poultry? Do we find? We find poultry in the farm. Then monk, monk is the person who lives away from his family. So in Western culture, in Christian culture, there are monks and nun. Okay, so monk is a person like a saint. And where does he live? He lives in a monastery. So monastery is also place where usually these monks live, and they do some kind of rituals, worships, etc. Okay, so that was about monk and monastery. Then let's go to the next one, is that fish. So usually we all know, where does fish live? Fish live in water, natural water, but if they are kept, if they are caught and if they are kept, they are kept in aquarium. If you have visited a restaurant or hotel or at some maybe usually it is waiting room or lounge, so that time you'll come to know that there is usually an aquarium kept. So in that aquarium you'll find fish. Birds, naturally birds live in the nature, they have their own nests. But those birds which are domestic or they are caught, the caught birds are kept in aviary. Horse, horse is kept in stable. Okay, so that was the animals and their living places. Now here we people are going to do another relationship here, and this relationship is going to be a lengthy part. You people have to remember about this, because in today's world there are a lot of new topics, there are a lot of new studies which are emerging, and everything has their own science, their own branch, their own specialization, specification. And so therefore it is necessary that we should know about such different study and their topics. So first of all, you people see, that is ornithology. So how ornithology is related with birds? Because ornithology is nothing but study of birds, scientific study of birds. So the word logy will come to know that it is study of something. Perhaps you people might have done with biology, zoology, or some other logies. Psychology is there. So logy, the word which is ending in logy, it tells you that it is the study of something, it is science of something. So ornithology, so that is the study of what? That is the study of birds. So ornithology is the study of birds. Then next is seismology. So what is seismology? Again, it is the study of earthquakes. People have discussed about earthquakes. So maybe it is Richter scale, and people have discussed about seismograph, which was an instrument. Now here the word is seismology. So seismology is the study of earthquakes. Then botany. Botany is the scientific study of plants. You perhaps you might have heard about I think that zoology. So zoology gets further divided into again in different parts. So biology, if you think biology, biology has two parts, botany and zoology. In botany you people study plants, in zoology there is study of animals. So something like that you people have to remember. But this is common, and we know about biology, zoology, botany, etc. But there are some new names, or there are new topics that you people have to think of, this like onomatology. So if you hear this onomatology, you'll think, what is this onomatology? Perhaps we might have not heard or read this word before. But you people have to try to find out more information about phonematology. You can use Google, you can use any books, general knowledge books also, or any magazines and journals also. So it is the study of names. So sometimes we know that what is in the name. So there are some people who study about names. So that study is called phonematology. Then next one is ethnology. So again, this is new and it is study of human races. So what do you understand from this human races? Do you know meaning of race? Because this word is having two different meanings. So what usually we get of race? That meaning is like competition. But another meaning of race is what? What is race? Human race. A particular group of people, simple. Okay? So maybe human races, we call that Dravidian people, Aryan people, Vamsh, yes, you're right, Varsha. So that is another meaning. So therefore, you people just try to know that ethnology is the study of human races. Okay, then come back to the point. Next one is ontology. So don't get confused between that ornithology, onomatology, and ontology. So what is ontology? Ontology is the study of reality. So what do you mean by study of reality? Sometimes we get some news these days. This is the maybe era of social media. So everybody is sending some kind of knowledge, which is always forwarded. We don't know whether it is real, whether it is fake, whether it is fact, whether it is rumors. We don't know anything, but we keep forwarding it. So there are some people who just try to find out what are the information they're getting, whether this is reality or whether this is fake rumors. So that kind of study is called ontology. Okay. Then in the next slide also, we people are going to talk about the same kind of topic is this study and topic. So let's continue with this new term, that is herpetology. So herpetology is the study of amphibians. Okay, so amphibians. So what kind of amphibians you know? What is meaning of amphibians? It just 1 minute. Amphibians are animals which can live in water as well as on land. So these are called amphibians. So herpetology is the study of amphibians. Then next one is pathology. Pathology is the study of diseases. So different diseases are studied in pathology. Next one, this is astrology. Okay. So now let's try to think about this astrology and astronomy. These are two different concepts. Okay. So we are going to think of this astrology, which is the study of future. Sometimes we people just go to an astrologer and perhaps we just extend our hand, and we ask what is going to happen with me in the future. So whether I'm going to earn wealth or whether what is going to happen to me in the future. So that astrologer usually tells everything positive, that you are a kind person, but other people deceive you. You are earning a lot of money, but money is not retaining with you. Something like this. So this astrologer is a person who is going to predict about your future. And astronomy, who will tell me what is astronomy? Who is astronaut? You people can unmute and speak. Astronomy or astronaut? the people are not just taking any kind of initiative. Be active. You can unmute and you can speak. If you don't know, that is okay. But you should too, sir, we don't know, you can just tell. Or you should try to tell wrong answers also. That will be okay. So astronomy is the study of space. And yes, you're right, Kuldeep. So the people who are going into space, they are called astronauts. Okay. So astronomy and astrology, perhaps it may confuse you. So try to be clear with astrology and astronomy, astrologer and astronomer. Then next study is that is called anthropology. So this is called anthropology is the study of man. Instead of saying man, we people will call it mankind. You'll think that if it is study of man, what about woman? So it is not like this man and woman, but you'll just try to read it as mankind or human beings. Simply, the people just try to understand that is the study of human beings. It is called anthropology. Okay. And again, there is term anthropologist. The person who is studying anthropology is called anthropologist. Then let's go to the next one now. It says paleography. So paleography is the study of writings. So similarly, there are some terms like calligraphy is there also. So calligraphy is the study of handwriting and paleography is the study of writing. So different kinds of writings, usually in the history, you'll come to know that in olden times, people used to write with the help of different instruments and different things are used to write. Sometimes stones and metals are used. So the study of writing is called paleography. Then next branch is ichthyology. So ichthyology is the study of fishes. You'll come to know that usually everything has specialization and different kinds of their own specifications they have. So the study of fishes, it is called ichthyology. Then next one, semantics. So semantics is the study of language. Instead of saying language, I would like to tell that it can be study of meaning, in fact. So study of language, usually it is linguistics. So when we think of linguistics or the word linguistics, it means that study of language. And semantics, there is other terms like syntax, semantics. Okay, so syntax is related with the structure of sentences and semantics is related with the meaning of that particular sentence. So instead of saying semantics as study of language, you'll come to know that semantics is nothing but the scientific study of meaning of that particular words and sentences in that language. That will be semantics. And linguistics will be study of language. Then let's go to the next now. It says nephrology. So this word, perhaps if you are coming in contact with the people, or sometimes we have seen that the doctors, they have just mentioned their specialization in nephrology. So when you heard this nephrology, so nephrology is the study of kidney and its diseases associated with kidney. That will be studied by this nephrologist. So nephrology is the study of kidney. On the next slide also, we are going to have the same, that study and different topics we are going to discuss. Number 14, that is conchology. So conchology is the study of shells. Perhaps if you might have been to a beach, so there you'll many people have that hobby to collect shells and cones. So the study of such shells and cones, that is called conchology. Then next one is hematology. So hematology is the study of blood. Then next one is craniology. So craniology is the study of skull. So perhaps when you think of our whole human body, or perhaps you might have come across with the skeleton. So that time, there is a particular skull which is part of our head. and study of that skull is called craniology. Then next one is mycology. So mycology is the study of fungi, burshi. Entomology. Entomology is the study of insects. This is popular, common. We have talked about this. Zoology, that is the study of animals. That biology gets divided into zoology and botany. So zoology is the study of animals, botany is the study of plants. Then next is occultism. So here you'll come to know that some words are ending with ism also. Earlier you people see all the words that are ending with logy, logy. So now you'll come to know about these words which are ending with ism. Okay, so the words which are ending in ism, they tell us about there is some kind of conflict. Okay, jala apan vaad asa manu shakto. So maybe patriotism is there, feminism is there. So these are the some words which are ending in ism, and the words which are ending in ism, usually there are two parts. So here also you'll come to know that this word occultism, it is going to deal with this supernatural powers. So what are these supernatural powers? Perhaps you might have heard about, people tell stories of such supernatural powers. So in older times there are ghosts, and usually ghosts visit on the dark nights, moonless nights, and perhaps they come with some their own lamps, and they are having their own maybe some rituals. Okay, so these are supernatural powers, something that we don't believe usually, like ghost, or there are some magical powers, that is supernatural. So occultism is the study of such supernatural powers. Okay, is it audible? Are you listening?
Yes sir.
Okay, thank you. Then next science is oology. So oology is the study of eggs. Different birds, they lay eggs, and their study is called oology. Again, on the next slide also, people are having this next. Virology is the study of viruses. These days, people come to know about different diseases which are caused by viruses. So study of such viruses will be called virology. Then malacology is the study of molluscus. So molluscus, a kind of maybe fungi. You try to find out more information about this also. Even I don't know what that molluscus, and maybe if you have studied science in 10th, or if you have done year 12th, you'll come to know about this. Next one is paleontology. So paleontology is the study of fossils. So fossils, fossil fuel, we people have heard about fossil fuel. So these days the petrol, diesel and oil that we people are using, that is called fossil fuels. Okay, so the study of such fossils will be called this paleontology. Pedology. So pedology is the study of soil. Those students, perhaps if you come with the study of soil, so the word pedology itself, it is going to deal with this study of soil. Then next one is taxonomy. So taxonomy is the study of classification. Whenever there is types, whenever there are some different kinds, so where there is classification, so that time it is taxonomy. Perhaps you might have heard about Bloom's taxonomy. So there is classification. Then next 27, it says orography. So orography is the study of mountains. Okay, then next one is selenography. Selenography is the study of moon. Next one is ichrynology. Ichrynology is the study of secretions. In different animals or in plants also, there are some glands which secrete some liquids. Okay, so that is called ichrynology, and it is the study of secretions. Histology. Histology is the study of tissues. Again, in different animals and plants also, there are tissues, and the study of such tissues will be histology. Nidology is the study of nests. The birds which make nests, that is called nidology, its study. Again, this is also commonly we people heard about cardiology. So cardiology is the study of heart, different operations which are related to these hearts, that is cardiology. People who do operations of heart are called cardiologists. Then next one is phycology. Phycology is the study of algae. Bryology is the study of bryophytes. I think that was all about different kinds of study and their topics. So people just try to get familiar, revise it once, twice, thrice, so that you are going to remember in one go. Perhaps you will understand, but you are not going to remember it. Okay. So all you people will just see now, we people have different relationship here, and this relationship is now about worker and its tool. So see, blacksmith is a person, blacksmith is a worker, and what does he use to work to make tools from iron? He uses anvil. Okay, yala apan marathi madhe mhanlo tar iron manu shakta tumhi. So anvil is the tool which is used by us blacksmith, lohar. Then next one is carpenter. So what does carpenter use to make furniture? He uses saw. Then next one is woodcutter. If woodcutter wants to cut trees, he's going to use axe. So axe is a tool which is used by woodcutter. Tailor uses needle to sew clothes. Laborer, those who are workers, they use spade to work. Spade, you can call it powder. Soldier uses gun to shoot enemy. Sculptor uses chisel to make statues. The next one is mason. Mason, he uses plumb line to build a wall because he wanted to just get accurate measurements and level. So therefore plumb line helps him to build a wall. Next one is chef. Chef uses knife to maybe cut vegetables in the kitchen. Doctor uses stethoscope to check the patient, his heartbeats. Farmer uses plow to plow his farm. Author uses pen to write. And surgeon uses scalpel. So scalpel again is an instrument which is very sharp, and if any surgery he wants to perform, so with the help of scalpel he performs his surgery. Gardener is there. Gardener uses harrow. Harrow is name of tool which is used to trim plants. Usually it is for cutting. And then next one is warrior. Warrior uses sword to fight a battle on the battlefield. Okay. So that was worker and his tool. Now we'll talk about another relationship, and this relationship says tool. And this tool is used for which action? So as we will get this example, needle. So what is use of needle? Needle is used for sewing clothes. So needle is used for sewing. So similarly, knife. Knife is used for what? It is used for cutting. Sword. Sword is used for slaughter. Slaughter means to kill someone. Vadh karne, hatya karne. Matok. Matok is used for digging. Matok means in Marathi you can call it tikav. Filter is used to purify. If it is water filter, it will purify water. If it is air filter, it will purify air. Steering will be used for driving. If you are driving a four wheeler, you will use steering to get direction. Then pen will be used for writing. Spanner is used for grip. If you are a mechanic, you'll use spanner to grip. Spoon is used for feeding food. Microscope is used for magnifying. Suppose that you want to do an experiment. So that time there are some organisms which we cannot see with our open eyes. So that time you people use this microscope to observe. Gun is used for shoot. Shovel is used for scoop. Shovel again a kind of spade, powder. Chisel, if you want to make a statue, with the help of chisel you are going to carve that statue. Then next, or is used to row. So do you know meaning of or? What is or? Have you been to boat? If you are going
No.
to sail in a boat, maybe in a lake or maybe in a river, so there is a boat. Okay, so the boat is driven by what? The instrument which is used for driving that boat, it is called oar. In Marathi valle mantat tala kay valles mantat ka boat chalavnyasathi je lakad astat baka te doni bajuni te hodi la pudhe janyasathi je vaparle jatat te and perhaps you might have seen in videos also rowing a game pan aste baka water game ahe hi yamade there is a group of yes Varsha, you're right. वल्ले असतात ते लाकडाचे ते वल्लवण्यासाठी रोईंगची गेम असते. यू कॅन सर्च ऑन गुगल, यू कॅन गेट व्हिडिओज ऑल्सो. देन एक्स इज यूज फॉर ग्राइंड. सो ऑगर, ऑगर इज यूज फॉर बोर. परहॅप्स तुम्ही बोरवेलची मशीन बघितली असेल. सो ॲट दी बॉटम साईड जे सगळ्यात खालच्या बाजूला जे असतं बघा, बोरवेल जे पाडला जातो, that is auger. So auger is the tool which is used for boring. Again spade, fowder can be used for digging. Shield is used for guard. So if you are going to fight a battle with the sword and shield, you need a sword and you need a shield. Okay, so shield manje dhal, protection karnyasathi vapru shakta tumhi. So it is used for guard. Loudspeaker is used for amplifying. So usually when you people are just using loudspeaker, so loudspeaker amplifies your voice, because suppose that it is a public speaking, so in that case your voice may not reach to the last person in that mob, so that time there is loudspeaker. So what is the work of this loudspeaker? Loudspeaker amplifies your voice and so that it reaches to the everyone. Okay, so that was about tools and actions, and we people will discuss this next. In short, worker and working place. So these workers, they work at which place? Chef. So where chef works? Chef works in a kitchen. Farmer. So where farmer will work? Farmer will work in field, in farm. Warrior. Warrior will fight battle in on battlefield. Engineer, engineer works on site. Usually it is associated with civil engineer, but these as electrical engineers also can work on site. Only software engineers, they work in an office. Sailors, they work on a ship. Pilot works in a cockpit. Beautician works in a parlor. Artist performs on a theater. Actor acts on stage. Mechanic works in a garage. Lawyer works in a court. Scientist works in a laboratory. Teacher teaches in a school. Doctor works in a hospital. Clerk works in an office. Servant works in a house. Okay, then driver works in his driver cabin. Grocer works in a shop. Painter paints pictures in a gallery. Waiter works in a restaurant. Worker works in a factory. Umpire gives his decision in a pitch. Gambler plays in casino. So do you know about gambler and casino? You try to find out about gambler in casino. Meanwhile, I will discuss ups and numbers. So roll number 1 is not there. Roll number 3 is not there. Roll number 6, 10, 12, 16, 17, 19, 20, 21, 24, 25, 27, 31, 33. These are ups and numbers. Because this is the last minute and you may get disconnected at any moment. So if you have any questions regarding or maybe the absent numbers, you just confirm. Okay, so in next class, people are going to have some questions and answers on based on these relationships. So better you people be prepared. You people can get the book called R.S. Agarwal, Verbal Reasoning or Analogy. From that book, you people can prepare. Come prepared. Or I will share the link in teaching diary also. You people can get access to that book there. Is it okay? So we are going to stop here today. So thank you for joining today. We'll continue in the next class. Perhaps tomorrow, I think that we have class.